Mamata Banerjee's moment today in West Bengal, a historic third term, a hat-trick, a massive mandate and a stunning political high after vanquishing a very powerful opponent on the other side. Walking into the Raj Bhavan with her nephew, Mamata Banerjee looked very much at ease, welcoming her invitees from all spheres of life. While the first row had her close aides Abhishek Banerjee and Prashant Kishore, there was a Congress representative too attending Mamata Banerjee's swearing-in ceremony. But BJP leaders were very, very visible in their absence. And while Mamata Banerjee was taking her oath, they were at their party office taking a pledge at the same time that Mamata Banerjee took her oath. And their oath was to fight the violence and launching a nationwide dharna against the killing of their own workers post the results, while Trinamool brought in the third term. The focus was shared between the swearing-in and the violence that had gripped the state. Here's what Mamata Banerjee told our correspondent Tamal after her oath-taking ceremony.
I just took over the oath only today. And after that, I have deputed my DG, my ADG Law and Order, and other important officials to take care immediate so that BJP cannot create any communal nuisance.
Mamata ji's silence speaks about her involvement. And she starts her third term with her blood on her hands. Woh apni teesri term ki shuruaat unke haath mein lage hue sane hue khoon ke saath prarambh hoti hai. Ye mera charge hai.
So the legitimate question on the news are tonight: when will the Bengal violence end? When will those responsible for it be brought to book? That's the question and the debate. Stop Bengal violence. The debate coming up.
You're watching the News Hour at 9. Debate number 3 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
And Nupur Sharma, I want to ask you. It is not every day that a woman chief minister is sworn in for a third term. And it was a very, very decisive victory that Mamata Banerjee got. Just for the optics, I want to ask you. Yes, violence of any kind is wrong and any deaths that have happened are wrong. And definitely there should be inquiries and there should be investigations into the circumstances in which this happened and who was responsible for it. But a third term, could we have avoided, you know, at the same time, the visuals, the whole, you know, pictorial, you know, irony of the whole affair that the BJP is taking an oath against the chief minister who's being sworn in for a hat-trick term in office for the third time running? Nupur, I'm just asking, is there any possibility of any grace in politics anymore?
Navika, without doubt, I mean, we've congratulated her on her victory, on her hat-trick. But should that overshadow the fact that immediately after that, 17 people died? Should that overshadow the fact that there have been 300 instances, no less, of violence all over the state? Should that also overshadow the fact that 100 such instances are coming and are being reported from karyakartas of Bharatiya Janata Party, ke hamare karyalay ko aag lagati, hamare ghar pe tod phod kar di? And can you actually discount the fact that she is on record saying during her campaign that all these central forces will go, fir tumhe kaun bachayega, tumhara kya hoga? Is she not answerable for law and order? She might have taken oath for the third time. Can we also discount the fact that she was also the home minister? And violence saw no rest. The way communal violence, communal riots went on, Dhulagarh, Malda, Bashirhat, you name it, it was there. Did she do anything? And now, the fact that she said it during her campaigning, that yes, and he's laughing, I find it absolutely absurd that the TNC spokesperson should be answerable for what is happening. I have a simple question. How many FIRs have been registered in the 17 deaths? How many FIRs have been registered in the rape cases? How many FIRs have been registered in the cases of arson and of marpitai and of todafodi? Simply that. Does it absolve her just Riju Datta of a responsibility Riju Datta, and answerability.
Riju Datta, respond to the charges made by Nupur Sharma of the BJP.
Navika ji, we all know that Mamata Banerjee took oath today morning. Yesterday night, when she was not even the chief minister of the state and she resigned and it was under the purview of the governor, she held a meeting with the top echelons of the police administration to take up this matter. There were violence in the state, there was sporadic violence where, as per our records, 3 to 4 TMC karyakartas have died and 5 to 6 BJP karyakartas have died. But last 24 hours after our DGP and our ADG law and order are reinstated, are there any cases of violence in Bengal? It has been taken up in the strictest possible way, and I assure you, Navika ji, whoever are involved in this, irrespective of their political color, will be dealt with the law of the land. Now, I also want to ask, when my dear friend Nupur told me about Mamata Banerjee's statement on record, are we forgetting the statements on record of BJP netas? From Dilip Ghosh saying there will be multiple Sheetal Kuchis, from Sayantan Bosu saying I will order the police to shoot them in the heart, from Rahul Sinha saying we will ask them people to murder people, bidwa bana denge, kaat denge, phad denge. So, you know, if you talk about all these hyperbole, when you incite violence, you are also responsible for it. Now, when Mamata Banerjee was taking the oath today, and finally the violence has calmed down in the state, Mr. Nadda comes to Bengal, and in an unprecedented dhanna, on the fourth floor of a party office in a AC room, he is protesting against that. This is probably the, you know, the best form of dhanna I've ever seen in my life. And what is he saying? Again, he's saying the same narrative what they said during the elections. Communal ho raha hai. Kailash Vijayvargiya saying lungi dhari log mara mari kar rahe. Arre madam, aap log communal kiya, aap log dharam kiya, aap log bhaga bhagi kiya. 213 Bengal ki janta ne 213 chapad mari hai. Ab to kam se kam ye sab chhod dijiye.
Riju, Riju, Riju Datta ji, Riju Datta ji. You know, let me just come in on one fact, that there is no explanation of a chief minister elect or a caretaker chief minister in our constitution. You are a chief minister, you are a chief minister. There is no governor's rule that was there in the last 2 days since the results were announced. I'm just making that factually correct statement here, because you pointed out that the governor was in charge. No, sir.
No.
Mamata Banerjee continues. She has
under the EC rule, madam.
She has given her resignation.
No. The police, no. The central no.
EC rule is only for appointments. EC does not come and dictate, if there is a rape, whether an FIR should be filed or not, or if there is violence, whether an FIR should be filed or not. These are things that are stated in the constitution
all
and the legal
thing.
I just want to say on that, but Nupur Sharma.
Can I just answer, please? Navika, first
there was no rape in
model
Bengal.
The EC model, please allow
no
me, Navika. Please. The EC's model code of conduct was only in action and implementation only till the day of counting, not after that. I don't know, Riju Paparath needs to do some basic studies and have some basic decent understanding of what the Indian constitution says. Secondly, you're absolutely right. Riju, please allow me to finish. I didn't speak over you.
Please.
When you speak about communalism, chief minister on record who said all Muslims should vote or block for the TNC. It was very well the Honorable Calcutta High Court on record 6 times pulling up DD's TNC Sarkar in West Bengal for blatant minority appeasement. And if you want to put somebody in the trial room, you should start with your senior leader, Mahua Moitra, who has not only justified, but plainly said, yes, we are responsible. Pagal ke haath mein matches de di, to basti to jalegi hi. The point is not kiske log mare. Point is log mare, you are answerable, you are responsible. And the fact is, we will stand shoulder to shoulder with our karyakartas. Yesterday, 11 people died. You don't know, last night some meeting must have happened. Today, 7 people died. It's on record. So no action has taken place after your meeting, when you couldn't even stop people from TNC celebrating on the day of counting and results.
Well, all I can say is this. All I can say is this. You know, I'm running short of time, but all I can say is this, Riju Datta, Riju Datta, while I do expect the BJP should have shown more grace at a time when Mamata Banerjee was being sworn in, you know, they could have done their oath taking a little later or a little earlier. Grace in politics is very important because people are watching you. People depend on you. People have faith in you. But on the other hand, Riju Datta, if such violence had happened in Assam, you clearly would have blamed the BJP. Even if there was a governor responsible, EC responsible, whatever. The question is, people have died. They could be of any political party or just common people. The fact is that investigation should happen and there should be action that there should be taken. And we wish Mamata Banerjee all the very best in her third term so that she can give justice to those who have lost their life. Thank you very much, Nupur ji and Riju Datta ji, for joining me on the News Hour. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Good night for now. I'll see you tomorrow.